And now a page from our Sunday morning almanac. September 19th, 1981, 29 years ago today, the day rock music fans enjoyed a long-awaited reunion.
Slow down, you move too fast. You got to make the morning last.
But it was on that Saturday evening that Simon and Garfunkel performed a free concert in New York Central Park.
Just a poor boy, though my story is seldom told.
A singing duo since school days, Paul Simon and Art Garfunkel first hit the big time in the mid-60s with The Sound of Silence.
In restless dreams I walked alone.
And followed up with a series of memorable songs, several of which made it into the soundtrack of the 1967 film The Graduate.
And here's to you, Mrs. Robinson.
Although artistic and personal differences broke up the pair in 1970, they did make a few joint appearances over the next several years, setting the stage for the Central Park relaunch.
I'm very, very excited.
Talking to reporters before the concert, Simon joked good-naturedly about their long-time falling out.
I always like singing with Artie. I just can't get along with the guy. Very difficult.
No. Garfunkel said he couldn't wait for the show to start.
I'm like a swimmer standing on the edge of the pool who's been looking at the water now for a couple of weeks, dying to get in.
Simon and Garfunkel.
And by the time Simon and Garfunkel dove in,
and it's against the law. It was against the law.
As many as a 500,000 fans were there to cheer them on.
Slip sliding away.
Song after song. In the years since their Central Park success, Simon and Garfunkel have occasionally reunited for concerts and tours. Their latest Old Friends tour, scheduled for earlier this year, is currently on hold, while Art Garfunkel recovers from a vocal cord condition. A Sound of Silence no loyal Simon and Garfunkel fan ever wants to hear.